Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to begin our OneNote series with 5 tips for Microsoft OneNote. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. First of all, if you have never used Microsoft OneNote before, I would like to show you how to bring it up on your computer. If I go down here to my search box and I just start typing in OneNote, you will see the application up here, OneNote for Windows 10. So just click on that and you will be brought to Microsoft OneNote. But first of all, what is Microsoft OneNote? Microsoft OneNote is a way to organize all sorts of random information that's out there. So think of all the things in life that you like to take notes on. You could take notes on house projects, you could take notes on school subjects, you could take notes on what I'm going to buy at the store, what I'm going to cook this week. Like every single thing that you feel like you need to remember, OneNote is a great place to combine all of those miscellaneous notes in life. Just think of it as a centralized bulletin board for information. So think back to school. You know how you have a 5-subject or a 3-subject notebook, or even for you really old school people, you used to have a trapper keeper? Well, think back to that line of thinking. You had one notebook, and inside each notebook were different sections that you could section off for different categories. And inside each section, you had a page that you could take notes on. So OneNote is kind of like the computerized version of that same thing. So the first tip I have for you is looking at OneNote the same way you would look at a multi-subject notebook. If you go up here, you can see that I already have a notebook created by default, and I'm just going to keep that notebook. But let's say inside of my notebook, I would like to organize all the miscellaneous information I have out there for house projects. I could begin by right-clicking right here and going to New Section. And for my section title, I'm just going to write Home Projects. And now if I look over here to the right, I have what's known as a page. So let's say I'm really ambitious and I'm going to do several home projects at the same time. So if I right-click over here, I'm going to go to New Page. So I can see over here that I have an untitled page, but let's say this is going to be my deck project. And then I can keep all of my notes down here for my deck project. But if I would like to organize my deck project even more, I could right click down here and go to New Page. And on this page, I could call this Materials. And I could also create another page for Contractors. And once I have those two pages on here, I can right click on the first one and go to Make Subpage. And the same for my contractors. I can also right click and go to Make Subpage. So now you can see up here that I have a home project up here on my section level. I have my deck project over here on my page level. And I have my materials and my contractors over here on my subpage level. Now I could even have a subpage level. If I right click here and I go to New Page, maybe I want electrical contractors. And if I go to another new page, maybe I want stonemasons, etc. So if I right click on electrical, I can go to Make Subpage. And then if I right click again, I can go to Make Subpage. And now you can see that this electrical page is actually 2 levels underneath my deck project. Same for stonemasons. I'm going to just click on Make Subpage twice. And if I close up my deck project, you can see that all of those levels disappear. But if I expand it again, you can see that these 2 are indented under Contractors. Now say I right click here again and I go to New Page. And this project is my solar panels. And underneath that, I'm going to put Providers. And if I right click on Providers, I can go to Make Subpage. So now you can see if I close these up, I now have home projects and I have 2 different home projects going on right now. So this is one way that you can use different kind of levels for organizing your notes in OneNote. So again, I have my home project section, my deck project page, my materials subpage, my contractor subpage, and the electrical subpage. And all of this is located inside of one notebook. I could also go up here and create a whole new level of notebooks if you would prefer to organize your information that way. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So for my second tip, I'm going to show you how to categorize or tag different kinds of notes inside of your notebook. So let's say I go over here and I right click and add a new section. And this section is just my shopping list. And I go over here and I have a page in my shopping list for groceries. And under here, I'm going to create a new page where I will shop at Kroger or I will shop at Trader Joe's. And each of those, I will also make a subpage. So let's say I'm going out one day and I know that Trader Joe's is located in the western part of my city, which is where I'm going today. So I'm going to click on Trader Joe's and go up here to this tag menu. And I'm going to go down here to create new tag. And the tag I would like here is West, because this is located west of me when I'm going out and doing these kinds of errands. And then I'm going to click the Create button right here. But let's say if I go back to my home projects, and I have put in a subpage right here for my materials for Home Depot. So let's say Home Depot is also located west of me. I'm going to go up here and also tag this as West, because Home Depot is also located west of me. Okay, so now that I have tagged both of those as West, if I then go over here to my search screen and I type in my tag of West, I can see everything that is associated with the West tag that I have put in. So if I know that I'm going shopping out in that general direction this day, I can actually get a couple of errands done based on the tags that I've given to these two shopping lists. So my third tip for you today is how to use freestyle writing inside of OneNote. Let's say I go under Home Projects. I'm going to right click on Deck Project and go to New Page below. And in that page, I'm going to say Drawing. And say I wanted to do a rough drawing of what I want my deck to look like. If I go up here to the draw menu and I pick any of these pens, and then I select this button right here that allows me to draw with a mouse or touchscreen, and my computer just happens to have a touchscreen. If I click on that, I can either click and drag with my mouse or I can drag with my finger and I can draw a little example of what I would like my deck to look like. And let's say over here, I want this to be 15 feet. And across here, maybe I want this to be 30 feet. And I'm just going to draw a really rough drawing for now for my contractor. A fourth tip I could do in here is if I right click on my drawing page and I go to New Page below, I'm going to call this new page Images. And I can actually go up to the Insert menu and I can insert a picture from File. And let's say I have a picture out here that I would like to add to my home projects of the deck that I am thinking about. So if I double click on there, you can see that I now have images of what I would like my deck to look like. And one great thing is that if your images actually have words on them, you can actually search by the words that are in the image using the optical character reader built inside of this. And finally, I have one last tip for you. If I right click and I add another page down here, and let's say I call this one Measurements, I can actually work out some of the calculations for my deck here. So let's say I go up to Equation and I just start typing 30. And then I use times 15 because this is going to be the square footage for my deck. And then I hit the math button and I selected my action as evaluate, I can see that the value of my square footage is going to be 450. So if I just drag this over here, I can now keep track of all of my calculations for my project. You can even use the equation button and the math button up here for much more complicated math like algebra and beyond. So you may or may not want to tell your kids that this exists because it will actually solve their algebra equations for them. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to 5 tips that you can use in Microsoft OneNote. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks again for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.